I have always been kind of obsessed with the holograms. I just really want to see the kind of holograms we see in sci-fi movies actually exist in real life. Back in 2019, I even tried making my own. I used an ESP32 with a 2.8-inch display and a clear plastic reflector to make it look like the image was floating inside the plastic. It was nothing new, lots of people had already done similar things, but it was still really fun to try. This new device takes a different approach. It uses an ESP32 S3 and a 1.75-inch display with a tiny prism cube sitting on the top. The image is reflected inside the prism, and what really impressed me is that it's not just playing back images, it's doing real-time rendering. Seeing a microcontroller render textured 3D object on the fly and display through the prism was honestly pretty cool. I definitely want to experiment more with this when I get a chance. All of this is just to say I really really love holograms. This is an air imaging display called Holoneo. From what I know, it's powered by ESP32. That's really cool. I'm amazed at what such cool devices can be built with ESP32. It might look a bit heavy at first, but it's actually really lightweight. And the design is super clean and minimal. On the back, you only get a USB port and micro SD card slot, nice and simple. Alright, let me turn on the device. Once it boots up, the screen pops on right away. I already saved my Wi-Fi info earlier, so it connected automatically without any setup. Here you are. Do you feel that 3D effect? If you look closely, it really does look like the image is just floating in midair. There's a tilted reflector in front of the display, like a little prism, and that's what makes the image look like it's floating. Currently built-in apps are Weather, Lyrics, Picture, Media, OpenAI, and Settings. But there's something bothering me. Cool, isn't it? Bluetooth connection is possible through the Lyrics app. It's connected to my iPhone over Bluetooth right now, so I'm using it as a Bluetooth speaker. It actually has its own built-in speaker, and since it can show music spectrum while it's playing, it also ends up being a pretty cool little decoration for my desk. This is the media player feature. You can load AVI files in MJPEG format onto a microSD card and play them right on the device. They look surprisingly good even with regular indoor lighting. It's perfect if you want to add your favorite characters or little animations and have them floating inside the display. The display on this device seems to be 240x240, so it's really easy to use videos or images that are already made for that resolution. Just drop them in and they will fit perfectly.
Who are you?
I'm an AI assistant here to help answer your questions, provide information, or assist with various requests. What can I help you with today?
Sounds good. What animal is known as the king of the jungle?
The lion is often referred to as the king of the jungle. This title highlights the lion's status as a powerful and majestic predator in the animal kingdom. Lions are known for their strength, courage, and social structure within their pride.
Okay, how many colors are in a rainbow?
A rainbow typically has 7 colors: red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. These colors appear in a specific order, often remembered by the acronym ROYGBIV. Each color blends into the next, creating the beautiful spectrum we see in the sky.
As you've seen, this device uses gesture controls. Swiping left or right moves through the menus, and swiping forward and backward opens and closes apps. I was curious how it actually detects these gestures, so I set up a limb motion in front of the device to visualize my hand movements. What I found was that it recognized gestures best when I moved my hand in circular motion, clockwise or counterclockwise. For instance, to move the menu to the right, I'd rotate my hand counterclockwise. to move it to the left, I'd rotate it clockwise. Opening apps use a forward swipe, and at first that took some getting used to. Closing apps requires a backward swipe, which was also a little tricky at the beginning. But after a bit of practice, I could open and close apps pretty smoothly. If the SDK or source code for this device were open, it could open up so many possibilities. For example, imagine using it as a portable secondary monitor. Designers could carry it anywhere and see their work more effectively. I think what we are seeing here already hints at the potential. Alright, thank you for watching. See you in the next project.